the cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. Teach me your holy ways, O Lord, so I can walk in your truth. Teach me your holy ways, O Lord, and make me wholly devoted to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. Open my eyes so I can see the wonderful things that you do. Open my heart up more and more, and make me wholly devoted to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like all of my days. I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to worship you. Shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar, the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the works of your hands. Forever I'll love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have. The sound of your name.
they walked out. Keep your eyes on the prize. Hold on. Your eyes on the prize, hold on. I got my hand on the freedom plow. I won't take nothing for my journey now. Keep your eyes on the prize, hold on.
Hold on.
Keep your eyes on the prize,
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Community United Methodist Church. I'm Pastor Rebecca Cho, and it is wonderful to see all of you who are gathered here in the sanctuary, as well as everyone who is joining us online today. It is my great joy to gather with you to praise God for all of the wonderful gifts that God has given to each one of us. And today we are taking a moment to especially celebrate the gifts that God has given to one particular person, Dave Shrewsbury. Dave has served our congregation as organist and director of music for 20 years, and we look forward with great anticipation to 20 more years. I heard at least. Today we will celebrate and appreciate how Dave has used his significant gifts to uplift those around him, just as God calls each of us to do. I also welcome all of you to take photos today. I know I will be taking out my phone and trying to take lots of photos. I welcome you to do that as well, and please send them to me after the service. Thank you. I see Marilyn is taking a picture right now. Wonderful. So now let us begin this wonderful day of celebration.
Please stand as you're able for the call to worship. O Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths will proclaim your praise.
It is good to praise the Lord and make music to your name, O Most High.
Proclaim your love in the morning and your faithfulness at night.
Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come with thanksgiving and extol God with music and song. Amen.
Please remain standing for our hymn, Lord, You Have Come to the Lake Shore. You can see it on the screen, and you can also find it in the United Methodist hymnal number 344.
Thank you.
You may be seated.
A very good morning to you all on this special and festive day. As a member of this wonderful extended church family, it is my honor and my blessed privilege to welcome you all as we celebrate and express our deepest gratitude to our dear friend, this gifted child of God, Maestro Dave Shrewsbury. Whether you've admired Dave's incredible musical talents from the pews, or if you've had the great fortune to get to know him on a more personal level, I think we can all agree that to know him is to experience an amazing example of God's love and the glory of her creation. For 20 years, Dave has dedicated himself to the sacred mission of inspiring this community by opening our hearts and lifting up our spirits through his passion, his enthusiasm, and the generous sharing of his talents. Dave, all these warm, smiling faces that you see here today, in person, online, and especially from West Virginia, yay, are a testimony to the gratitude and the joy that we all share for having you in our lives. Not only as our esteemed musical director, but also as a devoted spouse, a loving father, a cherished son, an inspiring mentor, a fun coach, a keen listener, a super stealth drone pilot, and as a dear friend. We could easily talk all day about what a special part of our church family you are. But we thought it might be a little more meaningful to put these feelings into some poetic lyrics. So as a sign of our affection and our limited talent, we offer this tribute to Maestro Dave. We are so grateful to have Dave. We are blessed beyond all measure. For 20 years, he's graced our church. He's such a priceless treasure. He has an awesome sense of rhythm as he tickles all those keys. He's oh so loved by our choir, though they barely reach his knees. His fingers are like magic. They move with such grace. He even looks like Jesus with his handsome bearded face. He's a dad of such adventure, from coaching to flying a drone. But when his kids get a little crazy, he might need to be alone. When Dave's in church lifting our souls, we wish he'd never stop. But we don't know that in his heart, he'd rather be playing hip-hop. Dave's talents seem so endless. He's such a gifted musician. But Allison says it ends right there because he's a disaster in the kitchen. We are so grateful for all he gives, like teaching music to our son Bryce. Dave opened his heart to a world of joy by showing him paradise. Someday God will call Dave home, and we'll miss not being together. But heaven will dance and angels sing as Dave plays postludes forever. Thank you, Dave.
Thank you, Gary, for that wonderful tribute/roast. I have a couple of greetings to share with you from a couple of people who were not able to be here today, from Betty and Larry Nilsson. Here are a few words. So Betty was the choir director when Dave started, and they live in Washington State now, so they weren't able to make it out. But they definitely, I'm sure they are joining us online, and they wanted to send these greetings. So this is from Betty. Betty says, when CUMC had to find a new organist in 2001, you became available. What a huge gift you have been for the church and us all through these years. I, Betty, found myself able to stay on as the choir director mainly because you were my main support. Your kindness and encouragement enabled me to continue and become a better director. Music and church is meant to touch our hearts deeply, pointing us to God's loving care for us, and you, Dave, were and are such a marvelous means of transferring God's words for us. God bless you, Dave, as you celebrate your 20 years at CUMC. What an amazing gift you are to this wonderful congregation. And from Larry, what a joy to send you this greeting for your 20th year celebration as organist and all things sound at Community. We would have loved to be there to celebrate, but some short tributes are the best I can offer. You came as a gift to us and especially to Betty. I knew she would immediately look up to you. She barely reached 5 feet at the time, and now at 4'10", she would look up even higher. Betty came to look to you as an ideal organist, bringing your gifts in so many areas of music on the piano, the organ, and the guitar. You also brought a wonderful spirit, flexibility, and lots of humor. Soon you earned the respect of everyone and raised our music program to new levels in several areas. And also, Pastor Bruce Pearson and Karen Pearson, who are, I can see them right there online joining us, they also really wanted to be here today, but were not able to be here with us in person because of the pandemic. But they have, we are going to also see Pastor Bruce later in a video in the service. But they have also offered a gift to the church in honor of Dave. This is a gift of a selection of music by Brian Wren, a well-known hymn writer. He's got 14 hymns just in the United Methodist hymnal. He's also a neighbor of Bruce and Karen in Wells, Maine. So included in the music, so there's a box of music that I'll bring up to the choir room. I just brought one as a visual image. So there's lots of music included in that, is some Christmas music that perhaps we'll hear the choir sing later at some point. So they send their greetings as well as that gift for the congregation. Next, I would like to invite Jean Preston to come forward. She has a special poem that she has prepared for this day.
Is it another poem slash roast?
I don't think it's going to be a roast. I think it's going to be strictly a tribute.
Hello, party. In celebration of this day, I wrote this poem, and not by intention, it ended up being as if it were from all of us to Dave. So I wanted to share it with you. The title of the poem is In Celebration. Our church's secret weapon is a treasure for all to see. It is our music master, our own David Shrewsbury. Long ago, as a 5-year-old wunderkind piano prodigy, our young Dave grew, as did his talent, but the talent grew exponentially. After high school, to Berklee College of Music, Dave did proceed. To further his education in music was his wish, so his loving parents agreed. God-given gifts did propel him, assuring he would succeed. An accomplished musician and composer was graduated, an impressive achievement indeed. Then to our church, here came our Dave, in answer to our pressing need. And that was our great good fortune. Of this we are all agreed. For as dazzling are as his music skills to provide a great worship service, his extraordinary humanity and his tender loving heart were always present, standing ready to serve us. So Christ-like, Dave is an inspiration to us all, and to advance God's ministry through music was in answer to God's call. These are efforts that cannot be bought. No earthly sum of money can provide them if sought. For when God's glory lives within you, it's impossible to hide. And yes, our Dave is a beacon, full of light, profoundly wise. There is no one better for us, for he is true and duly tried. Once one becomes a disciple, there can be no earthly disguise. The journey has been, 20 precious years it now has been since to us Dave first did come. 20 years of true faith journey he has bequeathed to everyone. The journey has been magical, and thankfully it cannot be undone. Dave's music ministry has been a blessing, so say everyone. Yes, his life has been exemplary. He is admired by all. For when we choose a life of service, God's blessings do freely fall. The evidence of this surrounds Dave as he continues to answer God's call. And as for you, Dave Shrewsbury, you stole our hearts, one and all. For you and your sweet family, may God's blessings continue to fall. And we, your loving church family, truly thank you for heeding God's call. So for all these wondrous blessings, I say amen for us all.
Thank you, Jean. And we have one final greeting, which is a video greeting that I'd like to share with you.
Hello, I'm Chrissy, Christina Sellards, and I was the chancel choir director at Community from about 2006 to 2016 with David, and I miss you all so much. And I wish I could be up there to celebrate you, David, but since I can't, I thought, wouldn't it be cool if I show everybody where you're from and where you got your start? Okay, come on, let's go inside. So I'm inside the sanctuary now at the United Methodist Temple here in Beckley, West Virginia, and I did find two people that remember David. This is his mom, Sandy, and his first music director, Daniel Spurgeon. Go ahead, Daniel, say hi.
Hi, David. It's so, so good that you were here many, many years ago, but I understand that this is congratulations for 20 years at your church. So it has been so, so good that you could follow in your music ability and serve the Lord.
Well, David, this is also something that I wanted to tell you that I remember about you is I could throw any type of music at you and you could just sit down and play it. And that was so amazing. So you really helped me out.
Hi, David. I wish I could be with you today, but this is the next best thing. And I'm so proud of you. And just God has blessed you, and you have poured out your talent and your love for music and worshiped God and led others. And I appreciate you so much. And I also want to thank the members of the Community United Methodist Church for all your love. Well, I remember we had an old Commodore computer, and one of the little games was something about three blind mice. And so it had the little jingle, and David would hear that, and then he would go to the piano and he could play that. And he was just, I don't know, 4 or 5 years old.
Oh, that's so special. Just a
little guy. Love you all, and God bless you.
We love you too, Sandy, and I'm so lucky that I'm able to be here now and make all these new friends. So we love you all so much, and hi, Allie and Linda and Colin and Kenzie and everybody at Community. Love you and miss you, and God bless you all so much. See you soon.
What a joy to hear our choir sing after so much time. This is really the first time that they've been together and able to sing in that way since March of 2020. So that was wonderful. I would now like to invite the children to come forward for this morning's children's message. Dave isn't at the piano to play Jesus Loves Me. Let's just sing a cappella.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Yes, you know, this is Jesus. Loves me. Jesus loves me. Remember that.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in the beauty wood, a neighborly day for beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you. I always wanted to live in a neighborhood by you. So let's make the most of this beautiful day. While we're together, we might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Would you please? Could you please? Please, won't you be my neighbor? Well, good morning, everyone. I have something special that I'm going to show you, but in a little while. In the meantime, I have a question. And that question is, do you have things at home that you have hung up that are really important to you? Things like certificates or maybe drawings that you did as a child. Raise your hand. All right, so I see most people. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. I hope that you take away two important lessons this morning. The first is that God gives each of us special talents. And for each of us, they are different. And the second thing is that God, once he gives you those talents, wants you to practice, to improve, and then share those with other people. And that's the theme of today's service. Because when we think of Dave, we think of two things. We think of the amazing talent that God gave him. And then we think of how he shared that with so many people. Not just the people in our church, but he plays at other churches. He plays concerts. He's all over the country sharing his music with other people. Well, some of you might not know, but Dave Shrewsbury has a close connection to Mr. Rogers. In fact, he has a plaque about the size in his living room, and the story is this. When he was about 5 years old, he would spend mornings at Grandma Shrewsbury, and they would watch Mr. Rogers on TV. And one of the songs that he listened to all the time, he was just learning, about 4 or 5 years old, learning to play the piano, and he didn't have the music. So his grandmother encouraged him to write to Mr. Rogers. And Mr. Rogers wrote back and said, Dave, I'm so glad that you like to play the piano, and I encourage you to continue to play. And he enclosed the music to the song that Dave requested. And that plaque is today hanging in Dave's living room, which is the reason I don't have it. Now, Mr. Rogers also had tremendous talent. His talent, slightly different than Dave, his talent was in writing songs that had lessons for us to learn. And he must have written dozens of songs, but I have three special ones that I would like to share with you. The first one has to do with people worrying about appearances. What do I look like? What do people think about me? So there's a song that I like to sing. It's called Everybody's Fancy. Some are fancy on the outside, some are fancy on the inside. Everybody's fancy, everybody's fine. Your body's fancy, and so is mine. Another song that he liked to sing is when you get up in the morning. Sometimes you're groggy and you just don't have the energy. So one of the things he did is he wrote this song to give you some pep when you get up in the morning. And it's the song that actually Dave asked Mr. Rogers to send to him. And it's called, It's Such a Good Feeling. It's such a good feeling to know you're alive. It's such a happy feeling. You're growing inside. And when you wake up ready to say, I'm gonna have a snappy new day. And then my favorite Mr. Rogers song is the one about sharing love. It's about sharing love primarily with your family and how you can do that. So the song goes something like this. There are many ways to say I love you. There are many ways to say I care about you. Many ways, many ways, many ways to say I love you. There's a singing way to say I love you. There's a singing of the songs that people like to hear. The singing way, the singing way to say I love you. So what I'd like to do now is close with a prayer. So if you'll fold your hands, bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the talents that you give each and every one of us, especially our children. We ask that you especially bless our celebration today and all the work that Dave has done on behalf of our church. We ask that you also encourage us to use these talents, to develop these talents, to grow these talents, and then to share them with everyone that we know. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, we do not have children's Sunday school today, so I'd like you to stay exactly where you are, because I'm going to need your help in the next piece. Now, as I looked at Mr. Rogers' treasury of songs, he had a lot of ones for different themes, but he didn't have any for how to celebrate a 20th anniversary of persons and organists at your church. So we had to have that one commissioned. So this song had been written for Dave as a tribute to him. And what I'd like to do is use all of your talents. We just talked about developing your talents, so both the children and the adults. This song has three parts to it. It has an instrumental part that we've commissioned, and that is going to be the children. I have instruments for you. Then we have the chorus, which will be sung by the entire congregation. And then we'll do some verses in between. So are you all game? All right, let's do it. All right, so we have the musical instruments. Dave, this is the part in the song where it goes da 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 da. Can you put those screens and lift that up? All right, so let me get these out. Pass those out. So a lot of you got kazoos. If you haven't used a kazoo before, I'm not sure kazoos are really big anymore. But what you do is just simply hum into them. All right? All right, so I'm going to conduct. All right, not bad. All right, I will point to you when the musical part comes up. Then we also have the chorus, and that's I'd like the whole congregation to sing along with me. All right, and the name of this is the Hymnal Man. So if you'll see the words up there, Dave, can you play an introduction? We love, play us a song, you're the hymnal man. Play us a song, you're the hymnal man. We love all that you play. Today is the day we celebrate. Today is Dave Shrewsbury Day. All right, I think they've got it. In rehearsal, this never happened.
I wish we had rehearsals.
All right, so a little again, the format will be there'll be a verse, we'll have our orchestra play, and then the chorus will all be done by the congregation. We'll do that three times. Introduction a long way. O'clock Sunday constituent. The usual crowd saunters in. They've been here for 45 minutes, practicing songs about good deeds and sin. Doug Laird is a real estate agent. Dave G is the chair of trustees. Anna Davis helps with the acolytes. And Rod prunes all of our trees. All right, this is where the orchestra comes in. Ready? Bring those bells. All right, chorus. Play us a song, you're the hymnal man. Play us a song that you play. Prakash are on finance. Kelly, Michael, and Nelson are too. Deb and Joy make up RSPRC. And Cherry Ann, she has the UMW. Jerry and Gary and Jill help the homeless. Allison plans all our walks. Debbie Hastings helps feed the hungry. And Andy leads Tuesday night talks. Hey, chorus! Nice and loud, play us a song, you're the hymnal man. We love all that you play. Dave helps Pastor Rebecca. Now she's been here for a while. Sermons and children's messages. We love up our content and style. Well, we come here when we're able. But Dave's here all of the time. So if this is a Dave tribute song, he deserves much more than a line. So,
celebrate. Today is Dave Shrewsbury Day.
As we were putting together the program, what we wanted to do is touch bases with all the pastors who were here during the extent of Dave's stay with us. So I'd like to talk a little bit about CV. He's unable to attend. He passed 3-4 years ago. CV Thomas was an important part of our church back in the late 1900s, the early 2000s. A couple of things were happening then. One, we had the merger with the Natick Church, and he was very instrumental in making that successful. He's also the person who encouraged us to do the whole renovation of the church, and he was instrumental in having that project come to completion. He was here during 9/11. That was an important part in our church's history. And he was here when we lost our prior pianist to Dave. She was a student at Berkeley, and she was graduating, and she was leaving town, so we needed to find another organist. And it was CV who had the foresight to go to Berkeley, and they had what's called the gig board. And a gig board is a place you go if you're looking for side jobs. So he put up Methodist Church on the rails, so he knew that most of the students didn't have transportation. So Dave saw this advertisement and he called CV. He said he didn't have transportation. And CV, to his credit, said, don't worry about it. I'll come pick you up at the train station. So he came in for his interview. Betty and CV, and I think Sherry Ann were part of that interview team. He blew them away because he sat down at the piano and he put like 5 or 6 hymns together flawlessly and just went one right to the other. So they're going like, yeah, I think we got somebody we like here. Now, originally, this was just going to be for the summer, all right? But obviously, the summer went on to the fall, the spring, and 20 years later, here we are. So CV picked him up every Sunday at the Natick Station, brought him to church, took him back, and eventually he did get a car. But the connection of our church to Dave goes through CV. That's all I need to say.
Reverend Bruce Pearson, as it says on the screen, was the pastor here from 2005 until 2014. And he would like to share a message with us by video. So I thought that it would be great in this service if instead of just me preaching a sermon, if we could hear from all of the pastors who had worked with Dave. And so I'm really excited that that's happening. So first we'll share a video from Pastor Bruce, then we're going to hear from Pastor Ted, and then I'll speak last.
A reading from the Book of Psalms, from Psalm 46, verses 1 through 7. It begins this way. To the choir master, a psalm of the sons of Korah, according to Alamoth. A psalm. God is our very refuge and strength, a present help in time of trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult, Selah. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God will help her right early. The nations rage, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah. Good morning, everyone. Karen and I are disappointed not to be with you this morning, but I'm honored to have the opportunity to say a few words in appreciation of David and his ministry. David, I was privileged to work with you for 9 years. It was great. Your tremendous musical talent and your ability to work collegially with everyone has made you a wonderful asset to Community UMC. It was a pleasure working with you, and I miss our working together. You always chose music that was appropriate for the theme of the day. And I was amazed that sometimes if you discovered that I was going someplace with the sermon that you hadn't anticipated, you would change the music on the spot to fit in. That takes tremendous talent and sensitivity. And you were the focus of something very unusual at Community. I served churches in our conference for 43 years, and Community in Wayland was the only church where the congregation stayed to listen to the postlude after the service. In most churches, people are getting up and leaving and talking during the postlude, but at Community, the congregation pays attention. David, it's a tribute to your skill and talent. If you look at the hymns in our United Methodist hymnal, you'll notice that at the top and or at the bottom, they give information about the hymn, about the author, the tune, the meter, and so forth. A few minutes ago, I read a passage from the book of Psalms. The Psalms are the scriptural hymn book of Christianity and Judaism. And you may have noticed that sometimes Psalms include directions for the music. Psalm 46 begins by telling us who wrote it and what tune to use to sing it. It says to the choir master, a psalm of the sons of Korah, that's who wrote it, according to Alamoth, that's the tune, a song. And at the end of each verse, it says, Selah. Now, scholars aren't quite sure what that word Selah means, but they think it has something to do with musical direction. It either marks the end of a verse, or it indicates a musical interlude. Since I've been retired, I've learned some things that I hadn't learned as well before. When I was preaching every Sunday, I know that in my sermons, I tried to interpret or explain the scriptures for the day, and we used the lectionary. But since I've retired, I've gained an even greater appreciation of the other parts of the worship service. Yes, our worship is about learning and understanding the scriptures and the traditions of the Christian faith. But it's also about aesthetics. It's about art and music and all of the associations that those bring with them. And they add a whole other dimension to what our faith is all about. David, I've learned that your ministry complemented my ministry in even more ways than I recognized at the time. You brought, you bring beauty and feeling and memory and inspiration to our worship and to our spiritual growth. I hope that you will continue doing what you are doing for a long time to come. 20 more years, maybe? Can we come back for the 40th? And to those of you in the congregation, I hope that sometime Karen and I will be able to join you again in person when the world is a healthier place.
Reverend Ted Crass, pastor from 2014 to 2019, has joined us today, and I invite you to share your reflection.
Well, good morning, everybody. It is so good to see you, and even with these on, I still recognize you. You can't hide. And I'm so glad to be here. This isn't the first time that I will have come to give a sermon, especially during my time here. Listen to Arnold, talk to the kids, realize he said it all better than I could say it, so what am I doing? And just kind of throw it away. But today's a special day, and so I'm just going to say a few things. We all know music has a special place in this community, and all of us know that it really has the power to move us, and a lot of the reason that we know that is because of Dave. During my time at Community, Dave taught me many important things. Things like the donut hole in the advertising business, right? If you don't know what that is, talk to Dave. I've never heard an ad the same way again. So thank you, Dave. Thank you so much. Somebody said over here, it needs a little bit of a roast. You deserve a little bit of a roast after 20 years. So, yeah. Thank you, Rebecca, for inviting me. And also, it's great to see Bruce on the video, too. The passage I've selected is from 1 Corinthians 12, verses 4 to 11. You'll recognize these words. There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them and in everyone, it's the same God at work. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good. To one, there is given through the Spirit a message of wisdom. To another, a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by that one Spirit. To another, miraculous powers. To another, prophecy. To another, distinguishing between spirits. To another, speaking in different kinds of tongues. And to another, interpreting tongues. All of these are the work of the one and the same Spirit, and God distributes them to each one just as God determines. This is the word of God living among us. Thanks be to God. All of us have been given gifts of the Spirit, and we remember that there's nothing fair about the distribution of these gifts. For example, it's really not fair that Dave got all the gifts, and you and I might have gotten one or two. One way that I have come to look at gifts, and particularly as described in this passage, is that our gifts are the potential expression, of what God is giving to us. They belong to God, they're given by God's grace, they belong to God, and yet God has given them to us. And in our hands, in our lives, they're potential expressions waiting for us to use. We know that Almighty God is fully capable of saving, redeeming, setting right everything. Everything that's gone wrong in the world by God's own power. But the truth is that God revealed in the Bible is the God who chooses to accomplish God's saving purposes through ordinary folks like you and me and Dave. God's chosen to need us, and are we available? So today we celebrate Dave's gifts and ministry. I seldom ever, if ever, heard Dave preach, although he came close in a few children's messages once. And there's an old saying about preaching and how we live our lives that's really a compliment, and that is, preach the gospel and when necessary, use words. Right? And Dave lives this way, and you and I can see it. It might surprise you, but among all the gifts given to Dave, and we talk about his musical talent, of course, but I want to talk about Dave's gift of hospitality. When a Christian uses their gifts of hospitality, they aren't expecting anything in return. They're serving others without any kind of a need for an exchange. It's a knack for making people feel welcome. Do people feel comfortable just kind of stopping by, showing up? Are you able to anticipate the needs of guests and strangers? Do you joyfully provide the needs for the needs of your guests? Are you open to people who might need a place to stay or to sing while passing through? The gift of hospitality can be used in many different forms, and it's living thoughtfully and generously toward others. And the way that Dave lives this out, and has lived this out for 20 years, obviously, and 20 more to come, is transformative for all of us. You know, highly accomplished musicians come through here all the time. You know, we have some in our congregation, of course, but professional or self-taught, they've come through. And I'm thinking, of course, about, you know, Chrissy and Jason and Christy. Great to see you all. Neil. Wonderful to see you, Neil. And the youth of this church, parents of whom are here now and saw your children playing the instruments that they learned in elementary school, middle school, and some carried on professionally, as Gary referenced Bryce. It is remarkable. Folks in our congregation of all abilities, he rearranges music for the gifts that we have. He writes music for the gifts that we have. For a non-musician pastor like me, he listened to crazy ideas that I had and would make them better, always. He would improvise on the spot. I'll never forget the day that Deb's grandchildren stopped me as I was just about to come up the stairs with my robe on, everything for worship. And Desiree and Donnie and Dylan said, "We want to sing a song today." Okay. And I just went to Dave and I said, "Dave, we got a song coming today." Right? "What song is it?" You know, into the phone, there's the music. It was beautiful. Nobody, I don't think, ever knew that this was not planned until this morning. And we had three beautiful children sing, make a wonderful offering to us. Dave takes the gifts that others bring and don't bring and weaves it into something holy. Holy for others and holy for themselves. Not every musician can improvise. All right, everybody has an off day. This is rarely true for Dave. Most of us can't ever even recognize it because he's so good at improvising. When my appointment at Community ended, I spoke to the congregation the day in December 2015 where just days earlier, bombs had gone off in France, Paris, and I had relatives that weren't far away, and it's another story. But the next Sunday, I was in the narthex, and I was in the back, and I was listening to Dave play, and I heard threaded through, completely different piece, the Marseillaise, the national anthem of France. And I still get goosebumps thinking about that. Some of you saw tears in my eyes. Another time, I would listen closely, and in the middle of Love Divine, All Loves Excelling, I swear I heard, "It's gonna be a Subaru song." Sorry, Dave, many of you know that he wrote that jingle and many others that have gone out all over. You've got to listen to Dave. As Bruce said, Pastor Bruce said, I'm just kidding on that last one. It's not true. I have zero doubt that Dave has a healthy musical ego. But I've worked with many musicians, and Dave is the rare breed that serves the music and others and brings hospitality to serve others. And that is Dave's remarkable, remarkable ministry. So here's what I believe. You can only extend this hospitality to others if you are serving something, someone greater than yourself. And Dave, we thank you and we thank God for your ministry here in this place. Amen.
Tough act to follow, Pastor.
Why did I choose to go last? I was trying to go in chronological order. Okay. The scripture passage that I chose for today is from 1 Samuel chapter 16, verses 16 to 19. "Let our Lord now command the servants who attend you to look for someone who is skillful in playing the lyre. And when the evil spirit from God is upon you, he will play it, and you will feel better." So Saul said to his servants, "Provide for me someone who can play well, and bring him to me." One of the young men answered, "I have seen a son of Jesse the Bethlehemite, who is skillful in playing, a man of valor, a warrior, prudent in speech, and a man of good presence, and the Lord is with him." So Saul sent messengers to Jesse and said, "Send me your son David, who is with the sheep." This David, son of Jesse, was known for many things. Of course, he was known as a boy to have killed Goliath the Philistine with his slingshot, and later he would become king. But here in this part of the story, David was primarily a musician. A man described as skillful in playing and a man of good presence. Saul was going through a rough time in his life and was acting very erratically. The biblical account suggests that he had an evil spirit, and perhaps he did. But he may have also been suffering from some kind of mental illness that couldn't be diagnosed at the time. There was one thing that would help to ease his suffering, and that was when David would play for him. Verse 23 says, "And whenever the evil spirit from God came upon Saul, David took the lyre and played it with his hand, and Saul would be relieved and feel better, and the evil spirit would depart from him I believe that this passage demonstrates how throughout history, people have recognized the important role of music in our lives. Music has great power, power to uplift, power to comfort, power to energize, power to soothe. All of these things are possible when the music is played by a skilled musician like King David. Our David, our own King David, son of Samuel and Sandra, husband of Allie, father of Colin and Kenzie, is one such skilled musician. One of the first things that I heard when I was appointed to this church is that Community UMC has a wonderful musician. Pastor Ted made sure to say that to me. The SPRC members said that to me right away, and I was glad to hear it and excited. And of course, my expectations were even exceeded. What I found in Dave is a person who is not just a skilled musician or musical genius even. He is much more than that. Because when he offers us music, it is so much more than technical skill. I found that Dave has a profound sense and sensitivity about what and how to play. We've already heard examples from Pastor Bruce and Pastor Ted of very similar things to what I've experienced and you've experienced as well, but I'll provide just one example. On September 12th of this year, we had a joyful celebration of the beginning of the school year. It was our Welcome Back Sunday. But at the same time, we were mournfully remembering the anniversary, the 20th anniversary of 9/11. The postlude that Dave did on that day wove together the songs My Country Tis of Thee, America the Beautiful, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace, and Let There Be Peace on Earth. It took my breath away. It was so beautiful and moving. And this is just a common occurrence. I was told that whatever it was that Dave played on that Sunday right after 9/11 happened, which was just a few months into his time here, whatever it was that he played was so soothing and comforting to the people. In the music that Dave plays during the service, whether it's the prelude, hymns, offertory, postlude, or any other special music, he manages to capture the spirit of the service. I am so incredibly grateful for the ways in which Dave uses his gift of music to touch our hearts so deeply and to help us worship God more fully. Thank you, Dave. And thank you to God for giving him to us. Amen. Amen. And now I'll invite Dave to come back up here as we join in singing the hymn, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name, which is number 154 in the hymnal, and the words will also be up on the screen. So I'll invite you to please stand if you're able, and let us sing together.
Thank you.
seated. We now have a number of presentations to Dave, and I'd like to invite Ginger to come forward for a presentation from the United Methodist Women.
Good morning. On behalf of our president of our local United Methodist Women, Sherry Ann Bryant, who would be here, but she is recovering from surgery, and also on behalf of all the women of our local unit, I'm honored to present the 2021 Special Mission Recognition Award. It is the tradition of United Methodist Women to present one or more Special Mission Recognition Awards each year. This honor may be bestowed on any person, male or female, who is active in ministry in the local UMW unit, the local church, the community, or in the workplace. It is not necessary that the recipient be a member of United Methodist Women or a member of the United Methodist Church. The award is a monetary gift given by our unit to mission projects in the U.S. and around the world through the United Methodist Women. The basis of this award is giving of oneself through Christian caring and sharing in mission, ministry, and service in Christ's name. This year, we are honored to recognize David Shrewsbury. David, if you would come up. We think for you, Dave, that being our organist, pianist, choir director is not just a job to you, but a ministry and something you love. Your creative way of playing music, especially for worship, composing pieces on the fly, as has been expressed here today, or while driving to church on Sunday morning, I've heard, adding additional instruments and musicians, combining our voices on a video, all fill us with joy, inspiration, and wonder at your musical gift. And we thank you for this. You've also reached out with your talent to accompany some of our high school students with their senior instrument recitals, to play with other praise bands, concert musicians, jam session groups, even organizing our own coffee house evening twice, I believe. Right, yes. Yeah, let's do it again. All right. Where they're setting up our live streaming, photographing with your drone or your camera, or simply tickling the ivories, what you do makes a difference in the lives of others. And thank you for setting an example for the rest of us in your service for Christ. Thank you very much. And on honor, we'd like to present you with our little
Dave, I know you just sat down. You're going to have to get back up very soon. So I would like to now invite Deb Ferrillo to please come forward, as well as Shirley Lowe and Mizey Settler-Rosa, and also Annette Porter. I'd like all of them to come forward. They have presentations also to make. So Dave, you might as well just stand right down there.
On behalf of the staff parish relations committee,
in grateful recognition of 20 years of service as organist and director of music at Community United Methodist Church of Cotituate Village in Wayland, Mass., we hereby present Certificate of Appreciation to David Shrewsbury. With this Certificate of Appreciation on this day, third day of October 2021.
David, both your music and you have brought joy and spiritual uplift to our church for over 20 years, and we are so grateful to you. Please accept this scrapbook of memories from all of us, and I would like to read the dedication on the first page. I want people to see it. This scrapbook is lovingly presented to David Shrewsbury on the occasion of his 20th anniversary as organist and director of music of Community United Methodist Church of Wayland, Massachusetts. We invite you to turn the pages of the book to see the incredible impact you have made on our church and on our lives. Thank you.
So these cards represent the message and celebrate 20 years with Dave. And looking forward to 220 more.
That's not working.
Dave, over the past 20 years, we have certainly appreciated your keyboard-related talents and skills, but never have we appreciated more your tech skills as you helped us through the pandemic-related restrictions and allowed us to have as close to regular services as possible over the last year and a half. So it gives me great pleasure to present this gift to you on behalf of all of us here and many who were not able to be here in person. We know you'll do some special things with them.
And now I have a special video presentation for you.
And the last
so much to Chrissy and John and all of the people that put that wonderful video together. And the great news is the service is going to be posted on YouTube later, thanks to Dave. You'll be able to watch that again. Let us now take a moment to share our joys and concerns with one another. The flowers that are decorating the altar this morning were given by the church family in honor of Dave Shrewsbury. I ask for continued prayers for Sherry Ann as she continues to recover from her surgery, but I've heard good reports from her, but let's just continue to keep her in our prayers. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Continuing prayers also for Dave's mom, Sandy, as she also recovers from her surgery. It was confirmed this past week that she has lymphoma. And of course, we're very sorry to hear that it is cancer, but there's a good prognosis for her, and we're grateful for that. And we pray for her full recovery and for her to be cancer-free. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
I wanted let us continue to keep the family of Liz Stevens, who a church member who passed away. Let us continue to keep them in our prayers. And I wanted to let you know of an update. The service time is different than what I had said last time. It will be Saturday, not this upcoming, not next Saturday, but Saturday, October 16th, if that's a Saturday. Yeah, at 11 a.m. at Lakeview Cemetery. So they're going to have a service in Connecticut in a church, but they're also going to have a graveside service in Lakeview that will be officiated by her son-in-law, who's a pastor. So please, you can check the Bryant website for more information. Let us pray for Liz Stevens' family. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Are there other joys or concerns to share at this time, either from those in the sanctuary or anyone online? Yes, Winnie.
I would just ask for continued prayers for my neighbor and friend Kathy. I've asked for prayers before. We moved her to assisted living, and 3 weeks ago she fell and broke her other hip and is not doing well. So prayers for Kathy.
Thank you. So sorry to hear that. Let's continue to pray for Kathy that she gets through this difficult time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Yes, Gail.
All of you know we've still been praying for Victory. She has passed her 2-year mark and is doing more than the doctors could ever expect. But unfortunately, their family has fallen upon very... I don't know how to explain the word, but the nurse that they just fired this week, their child could have died because of her neglect overnight while the parents are sleeping. She is to have nurses 24 hours a day, and this poor nurse did not see that what she was doing was wrong. So prayers that they find another nurse that can do the job and take care of Victory and her needs.
Gail offers continuing prayers for Victory, who we're grateful to hear has passed her 2-year mark, has done better than doctors expected, but prayers for the family as they look for a new nurse. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. I had the opportunity to see Bruce Hemian this week at Oak Knoll. He wished that he could be here today. He did ask me to tell a short story, and that is when he was operated on in the hospital in Boston, he thinks it was Beth Israel, that when he was coming out of the surgery, he heard this beep, deep, booming voice saying, "Haven't you gotten rid of that guy yet?" And he says it was Pastor Ted, and I'll always remember that. So. And I also saw, we're very lucky in Oak Knoll. They're only 3 rooms apart. I also got to spend some time with Marge Burrows, who's doing well.
So we'll lift up continuing prayers for Bruce and for Marge. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. I would like to invite Pastor Ted to come forward to share with us the pastoral prayer.
I'd like also just to, again, offer our thanks to Allison and Colin and Kenzie. You know, it's not easy to let other folks enjoy the gifts of your dad every Sunday morning for 20 years. Well, not 20 years, Colin and Kenzie, but quite a few years. But Allison, and we are so grateful for that. Let us pray. Holy One, on this lovely fall day, we gather in your name as your people to worship you, to thank you for your love among us, to lift up and thank you for Dave, whose gifts have helped us grow more deeply in you. We thank you for his family and their willingness to share their dad and their husband. And on this day, we know that we are joined in spirit by our sisters and brothers over the past 20 years, including those no longer with us who live in our memory and were touched by Dave and are a part of the music ministry of this church. On this day, too, we lift up those whom we've mentioned and know that each of us brings to this place our own concerns and worries and fears and burdens, and we lay them down right here so that we can receive the love and grace and forgiveness that you intend for us. Remind us, too, of our gifts and your desired purpose for us to bring your love into the world. We come to you and join in the prayer of Jesus, who taught us, our Father, who art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen.
Today's theme is obviously the gifts that God has presented to us. We're asked to use them wisely. I wish to thank everybody who continues to support our church, and you continue to do that either through the mail, electronically, or at the plates at the doors. Will you please stand for the doxology? With me in the prayer of dedication. Gracious God, grant us the grace to be extravagant in the gifts we give to you. Help us be wise and just in how we live with the resources we keep. Guide us in the way to lives that bear the fruit that is pleasing to you, lives full of mercy and compassion. We pray in the love and hope that is Jesus, our Savior. Amen.
You may be seated. And now it is my joy to introduce Jason and Christy, who will share a special song for us.
Thank you. almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is older than the trees, younger than the mountain, blowing like a breeze. Country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, man, mama, take me home, your country road. All my memories gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, a misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my country road. Take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, man, mama, take me home, your country road. In the morning, as she calls me, radio reminds me, my home far away. Driving down the road, I get a feeling I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday, a country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, man, mama, take me home, the country road. And country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, man, mama, take me home, your country road.
I now invite you to sing along to our next hymn, which is Pass It On. This is a video, one of many videos that Dave created during the pandemic. This one working with people both from Community UMC as well as Open Table of Christ UMC in Providence. Please stand if you are able.
Love to
Announcements. Next Sunday is World Communion Sunday, and also on Tuesday evening there will be a domestic violence march and vigil. If you're joining in the march, please be at this church at 5:45 to march to First Parish, and let me know ahead of time if you're planning on doing that. And also, the vigil starts at 7, so you can go to First Parish if you'd like to just join for that vigil. Also, today, maybe there an announcement about the there will be refreshments served after the service. The refreshments are downstairs in the fellowship hall, and there's a tent set up outside, so we invite you to get your food downstairs, and then if you're able to go outside, you can do that. If you're not able to, then there are a couple of tables set up in the fellowship hall. Were there any other announcements to be made about today or any other announcements? All right. It has been such a blessing to gather together with all of you as we praised and worshiped God and celebrated the gift of having Dave Shrewsbury with us for the past 20 years. We will close this service with a music video that Dave had prepared for last Mother's Day, All You Need Is Love, and then we will hear a postlude from Dave. Let us pray. Loving God, we thank you for sending your son Dave to be with us at Community UMC. We are grateful for all of the ways in which you have gifted him and helped him to use his many gifts to serve you and to bless other people. God, I pray that you would bless each of us gathered here and online. Let us discover the gifts that you have given to us and strive to use them to do good in this world. Let us go in peace. Amen.
All you need is love. All you need is. all you need.
Love is 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 all you need.